Good evening, everyone. Welcome to the Thursday show. How's everyone doing? Welcome back to Legends of Mario, where today we become the master of the disco shell. I was like, we're gonna get it on the first try. It's gonna be amazing. That's not at all what happened. Alright, but it was close. We did better. The Koopa survived, which was better than we had been doing. When you get that, when you get the low bounce on the wrong side, that's rough, so. I've had no practice, so I'm still just as bad as last time, but that's right, we'll figure it out. We will unlock the secrets of the disco shell. Oh, is he so far over? See, moving along with the disco shell isn't that bad. Slipped off that platform there. That would have been extremely difficult to recover. Actually, no, it wouldn't have. If I could have got back on the disco shell. Just go left. And then right. And then we'd be back in business. Disco shell, you need to keep up, man. I mean, I was way the hell out there to the right, but we weren't even close, buddy. Ah! I keep trying to get on the right side of it to low bounce under that business, but it's just not happening. I wonder if there's like, with the coins, I wonder if there's like an intended way that if you line it up right to bounce off the disco shell, everything comes out beautiful, but we're not doing that right now. Whew. Man, sorry for the yawning. It has been a long week. Oh, I expected more of a vertical bounce there. It's very hard to predict your bounce off the disco shell. Does this shell have an actual name? Is it called like a rainbow shell or something? Let's find out. Now I'm curious. Let's see. Enemies from Super Mario World. Nope, that's not what I'm looking for. There we go. Looking for that disco shell. A lot of these don't have. Subcategory of enemy. Let's try a different search here. Let's try SMW Disco Shell. Kamikaze Koopa. Huh. Fair enough. There you go. Now I can't see Jack, so I'm a dummy. Kamikaze Koopa. Fair enough. Damn it. I really think that dude's gotta live. I mean, we haven't made it that far yet to see. Oh! Live! Live? No! Damn it. I think we need to... I think once we get under the low bridge, we need to buy a little more time there. Because we can, in an open space like that, we can buy a little time. Damn. Too close to the platform that time. See, I don't think the Kamikaze Koopa works like the Fishing Boo. That's it. The Fishing Boo kind of moves with the camera. It felt good there for a moment, but then it just fell apart. There it is. Oh, you need to get there, Disco Shell. Come on, buddy. Gotta work with me a little. Think getting used to the low bounces this way is gonna be beneficial. Oop. You just get you want yeah you have no control once you get hit. There's just a range around the shell where once the bounce happens, that's it. Like that's the direction you're going. All right, let's go. Stick with the low bounce to the platform. Oh well. Wow. Weaseled right into that hole to grab a hold of some munchers. Well, somehow recovered that. Oh! No! This shot was going the wrong way. Alright, so... I think I have to go... Like, I've got to do like the initial jump here, where I go over it and then come back. And that will... So if I get a bounce... I start heading left, and then... Nope. Oh! That would have been just fine. See, if I need the... Damn. The shell to be moving right when I land on it. I think what's happening is... It's moving left. It is moving left. Come on. It felt like I was just gonna clear the whole thing, but I don't think the disco shell would be there to meet me, and even if I did clear it, which was probably not gonna happen in the first place. See, I'm trying to get left so then I can get the show moving right. I'm surprised we didn't get a muncher death there. Dang. Yeah, even if we kill that guy, kill the Koopa there, still gonna try to keep going. So I killed the Koopa and then messed up the low bounce. Man. Holding right and bounce too high. I didn't make it to the platform. All right. Come on, this time we'll make some progress. That was the bounce I needed too. I just needed to not hold the jump button like a big old dummy. The very first level of this hack had a kamikaze shell. It was just an obstacle in the way. Oh, shell, keep up. I felt like we had it there. Too far over. But again, I feel like there's only so much control I have over that. Goes forever. Oh man, that's no bueno. Means you get him on screen, you gotta make your move. As long as we're laughing, that's a good sign. Come on. Freaking shell. I mean, I guess it doesn't matter how far to the right, because I went really far to the right. If I stayed to the left some more, might have worked out better, but I guess it doesn't matter how far, as long as I'm to the right of the shell, it's gonna come for me. I feel like this thing doesn't home nearly as good as I remember it. Dang. Ugh. There we go. Whoop. No! No! That was it. Yes. Oh. That was silly. Now the strat might be to go under the paratrooper there. Couldn't get the shell going the way I wanted. I do, even though we're not making like forward progress in the level, I do feel like I'm making progress in controlling this thing. That time I was just late on grabbing the jump button to get the high bounce. So hard to control. Damn it. Just ejected me that time. Funny. Alright, get the Chuck coin. Let's see if that Koopa respawns. That's the only... Oh, shit. Okay, we're good. We're good. We're good. No! Oh, we didn't even get the information we needed. Oh. Didn't even get the info. But that was actual progress, and also shows that the beginning is the hard part of this, which is funny because it is both the beginning and the end. Oh, we had it. We had it that time. Yeah, there's just, you just gotta go. I think that's what I did that time. Like, I took the jump off the Koopa as, oh, that was some weird framey business that happened. I'm sure it's happened a bunch, and I just have been too, like, in the moment to notice it. Playing a ROM hack on an emulator, I'm sure. I really thought I was going to get the mounts. Sure encounter all kinds of business, like frame lag, and... I wonder if playing on actual hardware is any better. Maybe just a different emulator. A whole variety of them out there. Oh, damn it. I didn't need such a high bounce off of the purple Koopa there. Oh, we crossed 1,600 deaths. We're getting closer. Wow, he hangs off the edge. Just... walking right over. It just hocked me to the left. Ooh, man. This level is rough on the D-pad thumb. Holy shit, what are you doing there? Wow. All right. I'd love to see this show explained. Like, if it gets into how it determines the angle. Oh. If I got back on the show there, I mean, a good one. Want that straight up bounce and get flung. Alright, keep it going here. Yes! Yes! Wiggler, the easy part. There we go. Now we're going left. What an infinite nightmare. Going left in a Mario game. Come here, you bastard shell. No! Alright. We're getting better. We're getting a little bit better. Alright. If I make it past the purple Koopa on the way back and then die to either the disco shell from the ceiling hitting me in the noggin or... No! We took him out. The falling platform section. Yeah, it's just too high. I really tried to keep that Koopa alive. Oops. Trickiest parts is sometimes you want the on the low bounces, you want the stick to be neutral. You're not holding the D-pad at all. And oof. Because you want to get too far ahead of the shell. If you're holding a direction, that's what'll happen. Holy crap. I guess I juked left too soon. The number of times I just died on that coin is absolutely ridiculous. There's no excuse for it. I should at least be getting on the show every time. Up against them munchers. No! Damn it. I think if you're low bounce, if you're not in the right position and you're trying to fix it with a low bounce, I don't think that's gonna happen. The float floated it right into that wall. Nope. Stupid shell. Well, that's fine. Took out everything we wanted to leave alive, so. Yep. Yeah, I think our best bet is to go under that Paracoopa and hit him from the other side. Too fast. Oop, we did it. We're in there. You have to go right from the Wiggler, good bounce to the Paracoopa, and then over. Well, damn it. Damn it. Coming in too hot. No, you son of a bitch shell. Tried to float it up there long enough for the shell to turn around, but maybe that has to do with the side I'm hitting that Koopa on. Oop. Well, I hit it on the left side there and it seemed good. So. That's right, bumping into a wall just messes it right up. That's right, we had no ride home, so. That was embarrassing. Just jump right into those munchers. Nah. Shell went way too far left, and then I had to go off of him, otherwise that'd have been it. Need to be there, Shell. Well, we're a team. Team that murdered that Koopaling and let me fall on some munchers. Son of a bitch! This is a hard level. This is, I think, the hardest level in the hack so far. Far to the right. Too far to the right. Everything on that one was wrong. I'm not even gonna pretend. Shell, I needed you to come back. Yeah, just bounce right up into him. Take two. There it is. We were doing good riding it low there for a little bit. Timing that high bounce is critical, and I mess it up a lot, it would seem. Yep, mess it up a lot. Oh my lord. Alright, let's just chat about something to distract my mind from the pain. Big Binding of Isaac update dropped. Booster pack 5, god damn it. added like a bunch of achievements to the game, but I think it put all the booster pack items behind achievements, so now they have to be unlocked, which is kind of cool. But now I got a bunch of work in Isaac to do. Also, apparently there's a new character that is a big old pain in the butt to unlock. So, I'll be playing that in my spare time quite a bit. Also, there was an update to Slay the Spire. The third character finally unlocked. Added to the game. It's got an interesting, goddamn it, mechanic to it where... We played Slay the Spire a little bit on the show. Where it has these orbs that has like these slots for orbs. You can start off with having a max of 3, and it starts every combat with 1, and depending on the orb, it has a different effect. And you can like play cards to expend the orbs to get an effect, or just at the end of your turn, you will get a passive effect from the orb. Example being the base orb, which is called Lightning, which at the end of turn does 3 damage, but if you channel and expend it, it'll deal 8. So, not 3 damage to a random target, because, you know, it's an end of turn effect. Not all targets or something crazy like that. God. So, check out their new character too. So I got a lot of roguelike games to play, and then my daily commute has been... Nope, he's dead. My daily commute has been just Hearthstone on the train. I still have going through the solo content of that, the Monster Hunt. Wow. I don't know why the shell was so freaking far left. So yeah, that's a lot of fun. Of course, that Hearthstone solo content and Slay the Spire are very similar in nature. I don't know how intentional that could be on either company's part. Megacrit makes Slay the Spire and Blizzard. I'm sure that their similarities are just coincidental. And they're not. They're not like extremely similar. They just have some similarities. And Slay the Spire reminds me more of a deck builder than anything else. I really needed you to get their shell. That's what I needed out of you. Apparently I fell off that platform for a split second, and that was the moment I tried to jump. Disco shells. Whew. So, alright, occupying the mind has not been working. Yeah, I think we can skirt right under him. I just got to make sure I get the big jump there. Ha ha! like, I kind of wanted to bounce off the Koopa in there, but I was like, no, we gotta hit the disco shell, and I landed on neither. No! And then he killed it anyway! it's hilarious. There's something that I'm doing very wrong with this shell. I was really hoping to be able to get through this Switch Palace with the Chuck Coin before the first break, but it is not looking like that's what's gonna happen. It's because of my inability to disco shell correctly. The big bounce there. Did not get it. Oh, damn it. Maybe the best idea is to just keep going. Yeah, that's it. That's why the coin is going up. If you never go left, you'll just leave it behind. I got it. Ha! Damn it. That time I just messed up the bounce. Come on. Well, now I'm stuck in the duck animation. That's fun. I don't think it has any effect on anything. Like, there's a way to do this where you just like you're skipping on a pond, you just go. You don't really have to slow down or stop for anything. See, if that turtle spawned a little sooner, that's what would have happened. Or maybe I just didn't get over far enough for it to spawn. Maybe I'm just riding munchers like a dummy. This makes me miss bouncing on a saw. Oh no. Oh no, we got the low bounce. I released jump because I didn't want to overshoot. Nope. Not doing it right still. Obviously. We were in there. Well, at least we haven't died on the Chuck coin yet. Since we've yet to confirm whether or not killing the Koopaling matters, obviously we're gonna try to bring it on back, even if we do kill him. See, there are moments where, like, it feels like it all lines up. See, that would have been one of those moments if I bounced high when I wanted to bounce high. Try, and then we're gonna take our first break of the evening, get up, walk away. You know, we'll go to 1700 deaths, so four more tries. Just keep on high bouncing, and then go left. Of all the stupid ways to die in this level, and the damn Wiggler bounce. See, I felt like that's what you want to do. Like that's the intended. That's the perfect simple way to pull it off. Oh, that was 7. All right, we're going to take our first break of the evening. If you're having a good time tonight, I do encourage you to follow CO5 and go live again. Watch this replay on YouTube. I encourage you to subscribe to CO5 new videos or post shows. Find me on Facebook and Twitter right up there. Right back after this very brief break. Oops.